On today's show, it's all about the Zoomers. Grab yourself a brew and we'll start right now. And now we have finally made it to the Zoomers. Now the Zoomers are also known as Generation Z. These are folks that were born between 1997 and 2009, which means that in 2022, they're between 13 and 25 years old. When it comes to their investment strategy, well, it's going to involve a few things. The first and foremost is going to be education, which makes sense considering most of the Zoomers aren't old enough to legally invest yet. There's also going to be a heavy growth-inspired portfolio and a whole good amount of future planning, forging the future. One of the unique things about the Zoomers over the other generations we've looked at thus far is that, well, a good many of them are between the ages of 13 and 17. And what that means is that they can't legally invest. It doesn't mean that they can't, though, prepare for their investing future. And one of the best ways to do that is to, well, invest in yourself. So this is about education, learning about finances, and crafting a foundation for investment. Even if it's pretending, taking a pretend $1,000 and playing it on the market and sort of looking and see how you would have done so that you get a feel for how the market moves, a feel for red days and green days. That can be a lot of fun. And it can also really, really open your eyes to some of the volatilities within the market so that when you are ready to invest, you have a general idea of the way things are going. That will leave you less likely to panic when things get a little on the volatile side. Now, once you do hit age 18, the rules change a little bit. Does that mean you should jump in with everything you got? Not really. You do want to get your feet wet with investing, but the best way to handle that is to start small and then build in consistently. So for example, at 18, if you have a part-time job working at, like, let's say a fast food restaurant, maybe you can afford to take $20 off of each paycheck to put into it, into investing. Maybe you can afford more. That you would have to determine. You don't want to put yourself in a situation where you're over-investing so that it impacts the rest of your life. But also at the same time, you do want to learn some of the skills of budgeting your money and not wasting money. I know at that age, it is so easy to waste money on things that you'll have nothing to show for later on. So start small, build in consistency. This is what I like to also refer to as the snowball begins. Because that's kind of the way investing works. Investing is you create a little snowball and you sort of let it go at the top of a mountain. And as it grows, that's like your portfolio growing. It gets bigger and bigger once you get to the point that you start bringing in dividends and compounding dividends. That snowball starts to get bigger and bigger and bigger. And of course, at the bottom of the hill, that's retirement. And you've got a long ways to go to get there. Imagine the size of that snowball by the time it gets there. Quite honestly, anybody who's starting off on the right foot at 18 with investing and learning how to invest, learning how to grow their wealth, they're going to have a fantastic future. And the word millionaire will probably come up in their lexicon sooner than they can even believe it. So let's talk a little bit about our investment accounts. In each of our groups, we've talked about the TFSA and the RRSP, and they do play a role with the Zoomers as well. So the TFSA will be your primary account for long-term investments. One thing you want to definitely do is you want to be sure to know how much contribution room you have. You can do that by going into the CRA website. So if you don't yet have access to the CRA, then you want to definitely sign up and get access so you can go in and see. Because you are younger, you won't have as big of a contribution room, so you definitely want to know how much you have. There may not be any danger that you're going to hit it, but at the same time, it's still good to know because you don't want to get into a situation where you're putting too much money into your TFSA and overshooting that contribution room. There is a fee when you do that, and you really don't want to be paying it. Now, your RRSP will mostly be reserved for American dividend stocks. So if you are investing in American dividend stocks, throw that into your RRSP. For the most part, you're not going to use your RRSP because you want to reserve the room in your RRSP for later on in your professional career when you start making a lot more money, because then you can really utilize the RRSP to help lower the amount of taxes that you're paying. Usually at 18, you're not making an incredible amount of money, so taxes is not a super issue. However, there is a use for your RRSP. So if you are looking to get involved in the home buyer's plan, so that's where if you want to start saving for your first home, this is a great place to do that because you can then borrow against your RRSP when you get closer to being ready to actually purchase a home. So generally you can save up to $35,000. So there's also the lifelong learning plan where you can also put money into your RRSP, save it up, and then take it out for future education. You can withdraw up to $20,000. It's actually capped at $10,000 a year, but you can do $10,000 the first year, $10,000 the second year. So if you've got like a 2-year course, so that's perfect. Now the money that you're borrowing out of your RRSP, you would then have to pay back. Crypto is another component of your general investing strategy for the Zoomer. So when it comes to cryptocurrencies, they will play a part of your overall diversification strategy. We're looking at about a 10 to 15% share, which is a good balance. So within your crypto portfolio, you should also be looking to further diversify. But what I mean by that is about 60 to 75% of your crypto should be high utility coins. These are coins such as like Bitcoin, Ethereum, Polkadot, Solana, Cardano, Matic. So ones that have a lot of utility and a fairly high market cap. You can also look at 10% that you can then use in a lower cap growth opportunity. And now, of course, you'll notice that it doesn't quite add up to 100%. The remainder should actually be parked in stable coins. So that way there you have some cash that is available in case you need it or in case of a buy the dip opportunity. Now, a little bit about the low growth cap coins. When you're approaching a low cap growth coin, you of course only want to invest what you can afford to lose. And that's because these coins are very volatile. You can make a lot of money fast. You can lose a lot of money fast. So you want to be a little careful. I usually think it's a good idea to initially invest a small amount of money, which I call my play money, just to get a feel for the market before you start trading with more money. Because you don't want to start playing with your entire 10% and then lose it all. That wouldn't be fun. Interestingly enough, sometimes if you jump in with everything and you do have a bad experience, that can sometimes taint your entire feelings towards investing. And that's definitely not something you want to do. You always want to go in with your eyes wide open, and you want to go in almost just to test things first before you make any kind of bigger commitments. Here's another piece of advice that I think is really good, and that is don't get attached to a specific coin. Once its initial growth pumps are complete, it's time to move on, because you will see, especially in meme coins, there's a cycle to the way coins work. A lot of times a meme coin will come out, people will be excited about the meme, whichever Eno of the week it is, and a lot of people will start jumping in on it. The price will go up, you will make some money, but you don't want to stay on that train forever, because what will happen is after a while that price will eventually peak, and then it will fall down and it will find some kind of an equilibrium where the price is going to stay or might continue to go down. It may go up a little bit here and there afterwards, but usually by then most people have already moved on to the next Inu coin or whatever meme coin it's going to be. So you want to be one of those people moving on if this is what you're playing at to get some growth within your crypto portfolio. Take profits. So keep in mind, when I said that you should be playing with about 10% of your crypto portfolio, if you make a crazy return, all of a sudden you're no longer playing with 10%. You may all of a sudden be playing with 15%. So take that additional 5% in profits that you made, move those over to a stable crypto coin. Or maybe put a little bit of it into your stable coin, depending on whether or not it's a good time to buy. If everything's up near all-time highs, you probably want to move it to your stable coin and wait for, let's say you're investing in Bitcoin, wait for Bitcoin to come back down a little bit and then purchase your Bitcoin. And that's the fun thing. Once you get into crypto and you get that opportunity to really sort of see the way the market moves and behaves, you'll become to a point that you'll be able to almost by intuition alone see when a good entry point is coming up. So that's kind of one of the fantastic things that the Zoomers, the excitement that Zoomers have as they're learning this stuff for the first time. So let's talk a little bit about swing trading. Swing trading is a very risky form of trading. Now, where we were talking about some of the low cap investment coins, that's a little bit like swing trading, but really not. It's close. And that's probably about as dangerous as you want to go, because I do not recommend swing trading for novice traders. Of course, there will be some of you who are like, I'm going to do it anyway. So if you do try to swing trade, keep these following things in mind. You want to trade with a strategy. So you want to know where you're getting in, where you're getting out, and you want to have stop losses. Stop losses are basically limit sells. So if it falls below a certain price, you're definitely getting out. And you really, 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 really want to put a lot of emphasis on the education side. There's a lot of great content out there on swing trading. You want to definitely grab some of that. I'm even going to be doing a video in the new year. You also do not want to blindly listen to YouTubers or things like Wall Street Bets. So if somebody says stock A is going to the moon, well, chances are any opportunity to make a good swing trade on stock A has already passed. And if anything, if you jump in at that point, all you're doing is providing money to the people who are already on their way out of that stock, who are taking your money and everybody else's money. So you just don't want to do it. If anything, if a YouTuber or Wall Street Bets, if they are pumping a stock, if you're really interested in the stock, just at least do your due diligence. Go in and look at the stock. And I still say I would rather miss out on an opportunity like that than take the chances of feeding a YouTuber's pockets. Because, you know, I'm not saying all YouTubers are out there trying to fill their pockets, but there are a lot of them, especially in the US market, where they pump and dump stocks like crazy. It's just, to me, that's just morally not the best thing to be doing. So if I ever mention a stock and say it's worth picking up, do your due diligence. Do not blindly listen to me ever, because that's a smart way to approach trading. Also, with swing trading, be prepared to lose money. You're going to lose it. As I said earlier, it is not for novice traders. You will lose money, absolutely 100% guaranteed, when you're going into swing trading. So you want to keep all of that into, so you want to take all of that into consideration. You don't want to be losing money. Okay, so now hosting your investments. This is another really big one when it comes to the Zoomers, because when it comes to hosting your investments, that's a huge, huge point, especially for Zoomers. A lot of you may have your banks, and your banks charge incredible service charges. And there's also, if you want to get into investing, a lot of these banks, you know, they have minimum requirements even to get into investing. Like, you may need $1,000 right up front to jump in. So for that reason, I usually say grab Wealthsimple. These guys are commission free. They've got no service fees, no minimum amount. So you got $10. And you want to invest, you can invest $10. Simple as that. They do have a pro plan coming out, which will include a USD account. That's like $10 a month. But if you are doing a lot of American trading, this plan would actually save you a lot of money and would be worth it. More importantly, they have their cash card. Now, their cash card, I find it fantastic, because on the weekends, they have a deal right now that's going into February, and it will probably continue because it's hugely popular. If you order food on the weekend, so, you know, skip the dishes, pizza, whatever, they'll give you 5% cash back on their cash card. And their cash card is really cool. Like, if you and your friends decide to just go to the pizza place and you just want to split a pizza, that card will actually do the splitting for you. It's almost magic. So definitely awesome service that they have over there at Wealthsimple. And of course, there's also ShakePay. Now, ShakePay is our crypto side. And with ShakePay, we got a low-fee crypto on-ramp, which is fantastic. They've also got their ShakePay prepaid Visa card. So it works a lot like the cash card over there on Wealthsimple, except for with the ShakePay one, you're actually getting Satoshis back when you make purchases. They do have a lot of promotions on, like over the holidays, they had a promotion that you could get up to 4% cash back, which was fantastic. They also had ShakePay promotion where some of your purchases you could get back in full in Satoshis. So there's definitely a lot of different Satoshi awards with ShakePay, including every day you get to shake your phone and get some free Satoshis. The Satoshi rewards for shaking your phone, it increases every day until you get up to 200 days in a row, and then you hit their maximum, which right currently at the time of filming this is 1,000 Satoshis. So you don't want to miss a day for sure. So all of my referral links for both Wealthsimple and ShakePay are down below in the extra info section. So if you just click on that and go down, if you already got, of course, Wealthsimple and you haven't gotten your two free stocks, just use that little code right up there. If you liked this video, please do me a solid and click on the like button down below. Right next to it is the subscribe button. If this is content that you like and you think you want some more, click on subscribe. If you click on that little notification bell right next to the subscribe button, that'll let you know every time I come up with another video. So until next time, thank you for joining me here today, and I'll bid you a fondadoo.